International aid has largely dried up since the Taliban toppled the US-backed government last August. Winter has brought widespread food shortages to an already crippled economy, and millions face famine as the worst drought for two centuries shows no sign of easing. Women face new restrictions and are largely shut out of public life, and there are reports of widespread violence against people who worked for the former government. The Taliban has been pushing for international recognition of its government. So far, no country has recognized the regime. Abdulkahar Balkhi speaks for the Taliban's Foreign Affairs Ministry. He joins us from Afghanistan's capital, Kabul. Welcome to DW.
Thank you for having me.
Why should the international community recognize and therefore legitimize the Taliban, given your track record on human rights?
The current government of Afghanistan, the new government that has come to power, is a manifest reality. And the world needs to engage with it, as the government that is currently in place has actually fulfilled the criteria. For a body to be recognized as official state, according to under international law, and in accordance with Article 1 of the Montevideo Conference, 1933, there are four essentials that they need to fulfill. Number one is that it has to have defined geography. Two is that it has to have permanent population in that geography. Three is that the government has to provide governance. The people ruling have to provide governance. And the fourth criteria is that the government has to have the capability of creating and establishing relations with foreign nations. So in our view, it is the right of the Afghan people. They have decided upon supporting
so you have,
this new
forgive
government.
Me for interrupting. I understand what you said, but what you said is that Afghanistan, the Taliban government, has fulfilled criteria laid down. That doesn't explain... That doesn't tell us what is how it will benefit countries like the like Great Britain or Germany or the United States. How will they benefit from dealing with and therefore legitimizing a Taliban government?
To call it, term it as a Taliban government is incorrect. This is the government, a representative government of the people of Afghanistan. It did not come here through. In an airplane. It was not airdropped. The leadership was not airdropped. It was not backed by foreign forces. It is the people of Afghanistan that this new government represents. And for the world, it is absolutely necessary, it is imperative to engage with this new government and accept the uniquity of the Afghan people for what it is, and engage with it in dialogue if there are any outstanding issues. It can all be resolved through dialogue and engagement. Using pressure tactics is not the answer to the problems that Afghanistan is facing.
Understood. Are girls still being excluded from education in Afghanistan?
No, that statement is only half the truth. It is not the complete truth. In Afghanistan, from primary all the way to university levels, all women are allowed to attend school and attain education. On public sector, from grade 1 to 6, all girls are attending school. And in a conservative society like Afghanistan, that comprises majority of female students. And we have up to 12 to 13 provinces where girls are attending from grade 7 all the way to 12. And the government, the state policy is that we will give every right to the female members of our society that comprise half the population, their right to work, their right to education, and every single other right that has been afforded to them in Islam.
So you say that you will give them every right under Islam. As far as the non-Islamic world is concerned, women have fewer rights. Women in Afghanistan have fewer rights than men. And just so we're clear, you justify that because you say that is laid down in the Quran.
That is correct. The people of Afghanistan have fought valiantly against two superpowers for 43 years for this exact purpose, to establish Islamic law and in an Islamic society, Afghanistan is the population is 99.9% Muslim. So it is only correct that Islam be implemented on this land.
Is it true that Afghan women who protested against restrictions on their freedoms in September were assaulted with rifle butts, tear gas and metal clubs by Afghan fighters?
No, I have not heard of such reports. I've seen reports of our security forces preventing the protests. That is because the protests guidelines were given by the Ministry of Interior that protests to take place, they have to first coordinate with the Ministry of Interior about the place and timing. So there is no commotion and no problems for people that are going about their regular work.
Does Afghanistan have a free press?
Afghanistan is a very free and vibrant press. There's no doubt about it. If you were here in Kabul, in Afghanistan, you would see channels ranging from AFP all the way to Al Jazeera to DW, members of DW. I myself have signed their letter of permission for work. And as for all the media that was present previously, are all active. Unfortunately, I do have to say that some media houses have closed down, but that is not because of us. It is because they have run out of funding. They were funded by foreign donors, and they have run out of that funding, so they had to close down.
So the Taliban has issued guidelines restricting journalism that they say contradicts Islamic or Afghan values. Explain to us that what that means.
That basically means that the laws that are sensitive to this society, for example, the laws of blasphemy in a Western nation, it could be perfectly correct to carry out such activities. But in a society like Afghanistan that is very conservative, that has gone through 40 years of constant war, such practices are not allowed.
Right. Afghanistan's economy has collapsed. It's undergoing a humanitarian crisis. We understand that targeted killings are on the increase, and your healthcare system is on the brink of collapse. This is as you face a pandemic. Just explain to us how the people of Afghanistan, the men and the women, have benefited from the Taliban controlling the country.
Well, the benefit is that we finally have peace. We don't have killings. We had between 200 to 300 innocent souls lost every single day in Afghanistan due to the war, the brutal war, the aggression that was carried out against the peaceful peace-loving people of Afghanistan. So that is one of the foundation of any state is that it has to provide security to its constituency, to its citizens. So that is one of the greatest benefits that the people of Afghanistan had been yearning for 40 years. And the collective punishment they are facing from the international community is very sad. It is very unfortunate. They are threatened with mass starvation because they finally have peace and they have attained their sovereignty.